The following question states that the diagram shows two sources of waves S1 and S2. The sources oscillate with a phase difference of 180 degrees. So both sources are off by 180 degrees, which means that if a crest is coming in, or this source is producing a crest, this source would be producing a trough. So they are off by 180 degrees. So the sources each generate a wavelength of 2 centimeters. So the wavelength is similar. They're generating the same exact wave or frequency. Each source produces a wave that has amplitude x naught. So the amplitude is even similar as well. So both sources are basically producing the same wave when it reaches P. So each source produces a wave that has an amplitude of x naught when it reaches point P. What is the amplitude of the oscillation at P? Now the wavelength of the wave is given as 2 centimeters, which means it takes 2 centimeters for the wave to complete one cycle. So a wave starting over here, it's going to take 2 centimeters, and every 2 centimeters one cycle is going to be completed. And the same is going to happen with a wave that is starting with at S1, and it's going to take 2 centimeters and eventually reach point P as well. So you can see the length over here, 13 centimeters, which means that for 12 centimeters, if the wave starts traveling 12 centimeters, that is 6 complete cycles would be completed. And then you'll be left with just 1 centimeter over here. So that means there's a half cycle that is going to be covered. And also, let's have a look at the other wave. The other wave is traveling a distance of 5 centimeters, which means that for 4 centimeters, the wavelength is 2 centimeters. So that means 2 complete cycles would be covered if it travels 4 centimeters, and it would still have 1 centimeter left to cover. So that means one extra half cycle of the wave would be completed. So this wave over here is traveling 6.5 cycles, and this wave over here is traveling 2.5 cycles, 2 complete cycles and 1 extra half cycle. So as you can see, the number of cycles that would be done by this wave and the number of cycles that would be done by this wave, they are going to be exactly the same. We're not going to count the complete cycles because they are irrelevant. So it's going to be 6.5 cycles, so it's going to be half a cycle ahead where it started off when it reaches point P, and this other wave would also be half a cycle ahead. So in effect, they would be meeting at exactly the same point. This wave would be meeting at 6.5 cycles, so that means one only half a cycle ahead, and this one would also be meeting half a cycle ahead. So basically, they're going to meet at exactly the same point where they started off. And the way they started off was that they had a phase difference of 180 degrees. So you had a phase difference of 180 degrees initially. So if you had a phase difference of 180 degrees initially, the phase difference would be maintained, because in terms of cycles, both waves are covering the same number of cycles or the same number of half cycles, ignoring the full cycles. When they reach point P, they would be, in terms of wave cycles, they would be completing almost similar distances, similar phases, and they would still be meeting with a 180 degree phase difference. Assume that this is one of the waves that's traveling 6.5 cycles, so it's traveling and covering 6.5 cycles, and then the other wave has a phase difference of 180 degrees. What that means is that this second wave, the another wave that I've drawn over here, this second wave is starting half a cycle later. 180 degrees phase difference means that it's half a cycle ahead. Remember, 360 degrees is one complete cycle, so 180 degrees is lambda by 2, or half a wavelength. So this is half a wavelength. So the other wave is starting a little later, or it has a phase difference of half a wavelength. So it's late by half a wavelength. So as you can notice, if these two waves end up meeting, when they end up meeting at point P, what you're going to notice is that the two waves are going to add up. When they get added up, this one over here is a trough. This one over here is going to be a crest. So they're going to meet completely out of phase. this value is going to be negative, this amplitude over here would be positive. If you add the two together, you're going to get zero. The same pretty much is going to happen with the other, if this is the crest, it's going to meet the other wave's trough. This one is going to have a positive amplitude, this is going to have a negative amplitude. If these two get added up, the answer is going to be zero. So the correct answer for this is going to be option A, which is going to be zero.